shuts my eyes and counts to ten. It goes in one ear out the other, ooh, one ear out the other, ooh, burning bright right till the end. Now you'll be missing from the photographs, missing from the photographs, watching through my fingers, watching through my fingers. In my thoughts you're far away, and you are whistling a melody, whistling a melody, crystallizing clear as day. Oh, I can picture you so easily, picture you so easily. What's gonna be left of the world if you're not in it? What's gonna be left of the world? Oh. Every minute and every hour I miss you, I miss you, I miss you more. Every stumble and each misfire, I miss you, I miss you, I miss you.
First matchup, we got Bien Ruby versus Gavin Howe. Should be a very good match. Bien Ruby is a very good ball handler and defender, and Gavin Howe is a very good offensive player, a shooter, also has a quite good dribble, so it should be a very interesting match. As of right now, Bien Ruby is the underdog, but get on to it.
All right, so you finna play Bien Ruby. How you feel that game's gonna go? What's your prediction?
My prediction, I feel like I'll win 11-8.
11-8?
It'll be a pretty close game. Ben's got some, he got some speed on him. I just feel like I got size and maybe some accuracy that he doesn't have. I know he's a good player. I can see he ain't skipping leg day over there. I feel like I can get him today, just like I got Sean. I mean, if I 11-2 Sean, I might be able to 11-0 him, but I'm not gonna be too cocky, so I'll make it a fair prediction like Sean.
You've been warming up a little bit. Does your shot feel on? Like, you feel like you better be hitting?
I'm feeling it today after drinking that Rays. Ooh, you know my shots are on today, baby.
All right. So you said you've played with him before. What do you feel like your advantages are over him?
More recently, I feel like, I mean, I obviously have the height advantage by quite a few inches. So I feel like I'd be able to get a few shots over him, even close up. I feel like I might have some upper body power over him. I mean, he does have speed on me, I'll give him that. He is pretty fast, his handles are pretty on point. But I feel like in my wider stance, I might be able to make sure he doesn't get around me.
All right, so you finna play Gavin Howe. What's your prediction on the score?
I'm thinking 11-9.
11-9?
Yeah.
All right, what do you feel like your advantages are over Gavin?
I'm way quicker than him, and I mean, I can shoot way better than you than him.
Okay. So he said that his prediction is it's going to be a very close game, but he feels like he's going to shoot very well. Do you feel like your defense is going to stop that?
Oh, yeah. Hell yeah.
Okay.
You can't stop that. I got the best
defense out here. Okay, bet. Well, that's it. All right, so we got Gavin Howe versus Bien Ruby. We're playing to 11, ones and twos, make ems after three. Take back everything. The fence is out, but the line is not. And I think that's all the rules. Oh, I think I said one by two, but y'all will shoot for ball because your record is pretty equal. If you miss, it's Bien's ball.
Good bucket.
Yeah, let's take a step back. You'll get an extra point.
5-2. Six, six. Like I wish my height was. Seven, seven. Nine, seven. Nine. Ten, seven. So you're about to play Colsonier. What do you feel like your prediction is, like, the score is going to be?
I believe the score is going to be 11-7. It'll be close early, but then I got more of a sentiment, so I'll take it from there.
Okay, you haven't really seen him play that much, but what do you feel like your advantages are?
My advantages are I'm faster and quicker, so I can just blow by him. But if he beats me there, I can just spin move off of that.
Okay, how confident is your defense? Because he's a pretty well ball handler. How confident is your defense?
I'm pretty confident. Because, you know, I've been in the gym, I've been lifting, so I can stay with them. Also, I got quick hands, so I can just swipe it when he's trying to go up. So, I feel pretty good.
All right, you're about to play Alex Braun. What do you feel like your prediction is going to be as in score?
I think score is going to be 11-9. If I'm thinking realistically, I want to say him, but if I'm thinking positively, and you can cut this out because I'm about to stutter a lot.
It's all good.
What's that word? If I'm thinking optimistic, I'm going to thank me. Because, you know, I got to have the self-confidence. Or else I'm not going to make anything.
So, in previous episode 2, you said the same thing about Gavin, but you actually ended up capitalizing and winning that game. You predict that may happen again? You feel confident?
I think the main reason I said that and then beat Gavin was because I put myself in that mind state where, okay, I know he's good. I'm not going to underestimate him. And that's when I capitalized. That's when I really started showing up. And, yeah, I feel like it could happen this game. But, you know, I'm fine either way.
All right, what do you feel like your advantages are as I see him play a little bit?
As I see him play a little bit, I feel like my advantages is that, you know, obviously the court run is double rim. He said that he has trouble finishing on it. I think that's going to be my big advantage because double rim, the only thing it really affects me on is threes. And I can really finish and get around. I feel like my advantages also is going to be height on him, be able to get rebounds. And also, I feel like this can go for any game. It's because I'm ambidextrous. I can really shoot in any position they put me in. He's left-handed. I can really lock down the left side because I know it best because I'm mostly left-handed. I feel like it's going to be a good game and go either way.
For today's second matchup, we got Colsonier versus Alex Braun. Should be a very good match. Alex Braun's first matchup and Cole's second matchup. They're both fast. They both can handle the ball very well. They're both very, very good offensive players. Should be just a very good match. Alex is a little shorter than Cole, but it should still collide and be a good match overall.
For today's second matchup, we got Cole Saunier versus Alex Braun. We're playing to 11, ones and twos, Makem's after three. Win by two, take back everything, fences out but not the line. And Cole starts with ball because he has the 1-0 record and Alex has the 0-0 record. Dang, that was a good shot.
Six two,
yeah. Six, four. Seven. Dang, good shot.
He like slipped off.
I know, I
Nine eight, right?
Yeah. Oh,
these aren't made of honey.
Hey, let's game talk.
Yeah. These aren't made of honey.
First game of the season. First dub.
For today's main event, we have me, Noah Marrero, versus BN Ruby. This is BN Ruby's second game for today's episode, which is a first. We've never had someone that's played twice in an episode, but that's just how the schedule was. So BN is playing twice. I'm not going to comment on myself for my skills or whatever, but BN is a great defender, good ball handler, also a good finisher, lots of moves in the bag, and it should be a good match. BN is the underdog for this match. I'm D1, he's D3. It should be a good match though, because I think he's a great competitor even for being that low. He still can compete with people at the top of the league.
All right, we got Ben here for a pregame interview. All right, what are your predictions for the score for today?
7-10.
7-10?
Yeah.
11, you mean?
Oh, 7-11. Yeah.
11. Okay. You think you're gonna get over him? You're gonna lose to him? You think you got any advantages over Noah?
Not really. I mean, he's a better shooter. He's way faster than me, so.
What are some main things you think you're gonna have to worry about when guarding him?
His 3-point shot, like he can just shoot it.
Yeah, he's a good defender. All right, that was a pretty quick interview. We got Noah Marrero here for a pregame interview. All right, Noah, what's your prediction for the score for this game?
If you want me to be honest, I think it's going to be a decent game. But, you know, what'd I play? I played last episode Jameson?
Jameson, yeah.
Okay, yeah, I'm predicting the score is going to be like 11-2. Just because I feel like I didn't do bad last game. Well, I did pretty bad last game, so I feel like I want to turn up this game and play better.
Yeah.
So that's my prediction, but next question.
All right, what do you think your advantages are over Ben?
My ball handling, for sure, just because I feel like that's my best thing out of all my skills. But I feel like I'm getting very consistent with my jump shot, and I think that'll help too, and my speed, but that's about it.
All right, what do you think your worries are for Ben overall? Like, what do you think he has that you might have to be careful about?
He seems like a very, very good defender. Seems like he knows how to defend ball handlers well. Like, he uses his body when you get in the heck am I stuttering for? When he gets in the paint, you feel what I'm saying?
Yeah, like, I get you.
That's defense, and he has quite a good ball handle too.
All right, y'all. We got the main event for today: Noah Marrero versus Bien Ruby. Did I get it right?
Yeah.
All right. Makem's after 3-11, ones and twos. Fence is out. Pass the line isn't. Call your own fouls. Is that everything?
Yep. And then shoot for ball.
All right. Ever. Shoot for ball, since you guys have even records.
So if I miss.
All right, that's Ben's ball. Man, that'd be like bothering the cameraman too. What the heck? It's not just you, Noah. Mine's 23.
Yeah.
That's pretty good. I ain't gonna lie. Better than I thought.
Wait, is it the lower
rim? No, the higher the better.
Always
the higher.
This
ain't. No, 23. This ain't.
This
ain't. 6-1. Seven, four. Time.
No.
Noah with the win. How you feeling?
Not bad, yo. Just kidding. I got my W. I won. My stats maybe got awful, but still got a W, you know?
Still got that win. What are you, 3-0?
2-0.
2-0. Oh.
I'm tired, though. I need water. I need some Raise energy.
No. Yeah.
Watching through my fingers, watching through my fingers.